Should I go or should I stay? Which road should I take? Do I say yes or no? Life is a string of choices and decisions. Sometimes we can answer without batting an eyelash, without second thoughts, without regrets. Sometimes we sit on the fence agonizing over what our answer should be. Sometimes our answer is a choice to not answer. When we are faced with major decisions that will surely influence our lives and determine our futures, how do we process the situation? Let me share some of my decision-making strategies. The first thing I do when I'm faced with a dilemma is I grab a pen and paper. It's easier to assess and process facts and figures if the elements are laid on the table. I gather the facts, list the pros and cons, prioritize, and analyze. I jot them all down because they're easier to process when they're in front of me than when they're all jumbled in my head. After I've written everything down and I still can't decide, I sleep on it. Experts say the mind functions better when it's rested. Also, the mind can actually solve problems during sleep. A lot of times, I trust my instinct. Call it a hunch, gut feel, ESP, or just plain common sense. If my instincts give me a bad feeling about a certain situation, I always weigh it in. Part of the decision-making process involves taking responsibility for the consequences of the choice, even when no choice is made. I remind myself that every course of action or non-action has a price tag, and whatever happens, I should expect to learn a lesson. Our future depends on every single decision we make every single day. The tougher the choices, the bigger the price, the greater the consequences. We all want to make the right decisions all the time, but if and when we don't, at least we can say we did our best. This is your life coach, Ruby Bayon, for DZRJ 810, The Voice of the Philippines.